You know, they're not dependent, right? They're not dependent on anything else. They know how to wake up in the morning, find property owners, call the property owners, create those friendships out of thin air. Regardless of what happens in the world and the market, at the interest rate, supply, demand, people, pandemics, markets crashing, dot-com booms, 9/11s, the market continues every single day. Closings happening every single day forever. They're going to happen every day forever if history is any indicator. We're never going to see a shortage of closings by any means, which means what? It means that business is unlimited for every single agent forever, right? And as soon as you can eliminate the thought that there actually is competition in any capacity is the moment that you start winning really big. So I'd like to start out with that as far as just a punchline for today, because that's really the, if you get anything out of this, that's the biggest thing I want you to get, is that literally competition does not exist whatsoever, because the only competition is between you and your prospect. Did you make them feel comfortable enough with you to do business? Because if they choose a different agent, right, it's going to come down to maybe a couple of different variables, but the largest variable to me is going to be, did we make them feel comfortable enough with us that we're going to work hard, that we're going to treat them right, look out for their best interest, be the most dependable, answer our phone, do everything that, you know, do it the way that we would have done it if it was our property. In my career was selling real estate, and even to the degree of coaching and selling books and speaking, it's because the way that I build business is focused around helping people do what they want to do, doing the deal on their terms, not trying to figure out how to, you know, make the deal happen even when there's not a deal. And I think that's where a lot of people go wrong, because when they get in the business, they're introduced to all this high pressure, you know, mainstream coaching strategies and tactics around, would you consider selling your house? Who do you know that might want to buy or sell? Oh, you don't want to sell? Well, what if I could get you this price? And da da da, go down the whole ladder of the mainstream coaching philosophies. And that's kind of what's brought me here today, is because I realized this and I want to create a scenario in the industry whereas agents realize that you can be yourself. You can be your own self. You can be your own hardworking, professional, honest self and win more business. We're right back on the phone. We do an open house and we get a list of everybody that shows up. The next day we
call
them. If we get realtor.com leads or, you know, networking, sphere of influence, what do we got to do before a deal's going to happen?
Call them.
Call. So at the end of the day, what we have to realize is that, okay, I want to have as many since, okay, Ricky, business is unlimited. So how do I tap into this unlimitedness and close as many deals as possible for me? Okay, since it's unlimited for every agent, how do I maximize and close the maximum amount of deals that I possibly can? Because now, when you realize business is unlimited, now your success is 100% predicated on how much you can handle. It doesn't even matter about how many are or aren't available anymore now that you know that they're unlimited. It comes down to how many can we handle at one time? People built a brand, okay? Then you can automate that once people know who you are. Because then all you have to have is something that keeps your name in front of them and people come to you because they know how you are, they know how you operate, they know what you're gonna do, they know how dependable and professional you're gonna be. So the problem is too many new agents I see are trying to create that automation before they've put the sweat equity in to build the brand. This is a great example. I brought this up a couple times. I've seen it. They'll do a giveaway and they'll have a great presentation for the giveaway, a great prize to win for the giveaway, and they do just a great job with the giveaway and they get 3,000 people's contact information, and then they just plug those 3,000 into their database and start sending the weekly email or whatever, you know, whatever they do with that information, but they don't call them. They're trying to create automation before putting the sweat equity in. Everybody has their own, everybody's business is like a fingerprint, okay? No two businesses are alike. No two journeys are the same. You could actually sit in a room, two different agents calling the same exact list of property owners at the same time and get two different results, right? Not to mention, if you call this subdivision today and another agent calls the same subdivision a week later or a month later or 6 months later, you know, even if you called them at the same time, you're going to get two different results because you have different personalities, different cadences, different times that people might or might not answer the phone. Maybe they're in a different mood. People change their mind every, 5 minutes? You could talk to them today, they're not interested, but then boom, they sleep on it and they think, I am interested. There's so many variables to this game. So you can't put your finger on one thing and say, this is the way, because everybody has their own path. But what do I think about it? I think using it as a personal branding tool, not necessarily, you know, if you want to acquire leads, you know, from that source, you know, use social media to extract as much data as you can of people in your local market. If you can hack the system to extract as much data as you can, names, phone numbers, emails, even address, I don't know what all data you can actually extract, you'll close so many deals. It's ridiculous that you're focused on how many deals you're going to close this year and for what. In 2023, you're not going to care how many deals you closed in 2021. And in 2023, the amount of business you do that year is going to be predicated on how many relationships you created in 2021. So why aren't we focused on the relationship side of this business now, right? And in 2023, it's the same thing. We're going to close tons of deals from the work we put in now, but we shouldn't even be focused on those deals at that time. We should be focused on 2025. Right? It's always this carrot that we're pushing out further and further. I don't like the carrot scenario analogy when I'm talking about goals, because there's a lot of unhappy people in the world who have these huge goals and they keep pushing the goal out. Every time they get closer to it, they keep pushing it out further and further and further. And I think that's good to a certain extent, but you can't revolve your happiness around hitting these goals that you're never going to hit because you keep pushing the goals out further. There's got to be a happy place where you're satisfied and happy every step of the way, but still motivated to hit these bigger goals. But we've went through a cycle of that, and people don't like picking random agents online. They've had a few bad experiences. Now we've been through a cycle of picking agents digitally, and now we're moving back towards, they want somebody they know, like, and trust, that they have a relationship built with, which has always been the case. But with digital coming in, of course, there's this wave where people want to try things out. But we're leaning back so far the other way towards people wanting and needing an agent that they have a relationship built with, and they know how they operate, they trust them with, you know, handling the deal. That's what's going to be most important moving forward. And the agents who understand this, as well as technology, you know, inches closer and closer and closer into the future, the agents that understand this are going to continue to thrive big time. Because they're not, you know, they're not dependent, right? They're not dependent on anything else. They know how to wake up in the morning, find property owners, call the property owners, you know, create those friendships out of thin air. When you develop that skill, that's when you're getting somewhere.